original right now?
We can drag this more.
It's like triangulating the correct pitch.
Now bears the world of souls. S-D-E-E-L-E. actually spitting in my mouth. I can't imagine. What? Would you rather be like Dick? Making sure that the amp is allowed to be up there.
Sorry?
Just making sure that the amp is allowed to be up there. Because I think we're starting. And if they need to present, I don't want to have them happen. Oh, yeah, let's move
it down.
I think probably. He was saying that. Blake, I'm trusting you.
Now. Thank you. Sasha Nikolai and Danny Wells, please approach the stage.
Archie Williams High School community. Welcome to the 29th annual ComAcad Shorts viewing party.
Ladies and gentlemen, I am Dan, your pilot speaking.
And my name is Sasha, and I will be your co-pilot.
On behalf of Sir Francis Drake, ages 1327 Archie Williams High School, and the entire crew, welcome aboard ComAcad Airlines' 29th annual short film festival, non-stop service from dawn to dawn.
Our trip time will be approximately 2 hours and 30 minutes. We will be flying at an altitude of 46 feet and a ground speed of 200 miles per hour.
We've got 12 production teams who have big ideas, written a script, and have brought them to the big screen.
Tonight, we will be showing many different genres: comedy, thriller, action, rom-com, and suspense. From an attempt to find true love to cold-blooded killings, these shorts are guaranteed to entertain.
Now, we request your full attention as we demonstrate the safety features of this aircraft.
In the event of an emergency, please assume the bracing positions. Exits are located here, 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 and here. The main aisles will light up in the event of an emergency.
Ladies and gentlemen, the pilot has turned on the fasten mask sign. One must take the strap and loop it over the left ear, then take the other strap and loop it over the right. It should fit snugly around the nose and chin. Please make sure your mask is secure before helping others.
If you haven't already done so, please stow your carry-on baggage underneath the seat in front of you or in the overhead bin. Please take your seat and fasten your mask.
We remind you that this is a non-smoking environment. Smoking is prohibited on the entire premise, including the laboratories. Tampering with, disabling, or destroying the laboratory smoke detectors is prohibited.
Now, at this time, please make sure your seat backs and tray tables are in their full upright position, and your portable electronic devices must be set to silent mode until an announcement is made upon arrival.
This includes your walkie-talkie too, Chad. Thank you for your cooperation.
After these first six films, we will hold a 15-minute Q&A session, then there will be an intermission.
If you have any questions, please don't hesitate to ask one of our crew members. We wish you all an enjoyable trip.
Now just sit back, relax, and enjoy the show.
Thank you. Okay, sorry I'm late. Traffic was horrible.
What can you tell us about the body?
Well, Detective, after we've conducted some extensive forensic research, we can deduce that he is dead. He died.
Yeah, I can see that. Tell me something I don't know.
Oh, he got stabbed.
That's why he died.
He's useless. Get this body to the morgue and get out of my sight.
What's a morgue?
Just get the body out of here.
Okay.
Any evidence of foul play?
No, I think he was playing by the rules.
Okay. Come on, I'll brief you what happened at the station.
Okay.
Body was found by the river. Several lacerations, but mostly around the neck area. I managed to recover this phone from it. It's in bad condition, but I was thinking if maybe we opened it, we'd get a lead on the case.
Why don't you just give it to me? I'll dispose of it for you.
No, I'm taking it to the tech specialist today after work.
All right, well, my day is done.
All right.
Good morning.
Yeah, I'll see you later.
I gotta get into this phone somehow.
Hey, I'm Officer David. We spoke on the... Do I know you? I've seen you somewhere before, right?
Yeah.
We spoke on the phone. I was wondering if you could crack this for me.
This thing? Sure thing. Come back same time tomorrow morning?
Yeah, sounds good.
See you, man.
Hey, did you crack the phone?
No, man. I couldn't get it. This thing's crazy.
All right, well, thanks for trying, man. See you tomorrow.
You did a good job. I don't need you anymore.
Let's see here.
Take as zero people who hated music. And there's five numbers in his email password.
I'm in.
thoughts.
Jason.
I've got to show this to the commissioner.
Almost had me.
What's up?
Hey, Lux, I found this creepy radio station, and I just want to show it to you.
Stephen Conroe once pressured his friend, James Martin, to rob a convenience store for some quick cash.
Isn't that you, Stephen?
When the police arrived, Stephen managed to escape, leaving James to be caught and take the fall. James is still in prison, but Stephen ran away to a new town, living in guilt of what he did to James. He constantly fears that his misdeeds will one day catch up with him.
This is messed up. Like, this didn't happen. Right? You didn't actually do this.
Of course I wouldn't. That's ridiculous. It's definitely just some sort of prank show or something. There are plenty of people named Stephen Cornrow. It's actually a really common name. It was probably just a killer joke between friends. Don't worry about it.
Alex, are you still there?
Stephen Conroe has killed a woman at 27 Winding Lane. He hated her for what she said, yet all she did was tell everyone the truth. Who knew that honesty could hurt so much?
I'm sorry. Well, I know. No, it said the road was closed, but it should be fine. No, I'm not making up excuses. No, I won't be late. No, not like last time. Look, hey, I'm sorry. Look, I really need to go home. It's way too late for me to go another way. My house is up there. No one else will see.
I'm sorry, but this street is closed for maintenance until further notice.
What are you trying to do? Is this some kind of joke?
I understand your frustration, but I can't let you go any further. The street has developed a fault. You can file any complaints with our PR office.
The street looks fine. You didn't even have any equipment.
We had to move our equipment off-site for the moment.
You're doing maintenance, but you don't need equipment. Look, I appreciate it, but I really need to get home.
Just a friendly reminder, we are not liable or accountable for any accidents, as I'm sure you know.
Oh dear, another one in the loop. I know, it's the third one this week.
Please note that this street is undergoing maintenance.
What the hell? Hello? Hello?
Another bolt attached. Oh, so it'll fix itself. Excellent. What about that person from earlier? Yeah. No? No way to get him out? Well, the maintenance is almost complete.
Please note that this street is undergoing maintenance.
The house is all right, but then why am I still stuck? Look, I get that I messed up. Can I just go? Why can't I go? Why am I stuck? Look, okay, I'm leaving. I'll go. I just hope you figured it out.
here. We've got enough canned goods to last this week.
What happens when we eat all the food?
Well, we have to keep the dog.
No.
We know how to hunt. We know how to grow vegetables. We'll be fine.
Why can't everyone just go back to working together like before?
Not everybody has a strong will to survive. They're frightened. They may have starved.
Thank you.
Get out on the car. I'm gonna wash the car. I've been to the mall all week in Paris. I have a new
Yeah.
see, we have all put a lot of work into these films. As editors, writers, actors, directors, they are all our original creations.
We are so happy to have you here. It's been a rough year with COVID, but we are lucky enough to be back together and in person.
We will now begin the first Q&A session. Would the production teams that were just presented please come forward?
Stuff. So any sort of
meaning that could be pulled from it. You know, it's just supposed to be kind of, it doesn't necessarily have like a purpose. Like, it's not supposed to tell you anything specifically. It's just about some guy, you know, so. This guy.
All right, we have time for one more question. Let me take yours.
What was the steepest learning curve? Like, was it editing that was the hardest, or script writing, or shooting the film? Well, I feel like usually in the beginning of the year we start learning how to edit, but because of COVID last year, I never learned how to edit. And our group is full of new ComAcaders, juniors and seniors. So I think learning the editing and production process took a while. Luckily, we had Dexter who already knew how. But yeah, it was difficult to start learning how to do that when we had such a great familiar year last year. But we ended up doing it, and it ended up fine.
I'd also like to add that I think we can all agree, learning how to deal with 12-year-olds. It's a good one.
Yeah. All right, well, that wraps up our first Q&A session. Thank you for all the questions we've got, and can we get a big round of applause for our students? Also, since the flight is free, we have some envelopes being passed around for donations. Please donate to ComAcad Airlines so we can continue our great work.
Kick you out of the band just for a little
bit. I like how you're playing through the
classic
game.
I don't know if it's my song. We're going to be doing the Galen game. Thank you.
that it, or what are we doing next?
If you guys want to be sort of quietly up stuff, feel free to get rid of stuff at any point, because I think that's probably going to be it for the music.
We're not going to get to play and we'll let everybody leave.
You can if you want. It's just more, it's just a longer sort of night for you if you want.
I don't
like
mind.
I don't mind.
Do you guys want to put jam outdoors? It'd be kind of fun.
Yeah.
It will be a short jam, but I mean, you do have to clean up for a little while, so you're welcome to stay
for
right
sure.
May I have this?
Ladies and gentlemen, if you would please take your seats for our second half of the show!
Blake, you have perfect pitch, right?
Yeah.
He's perfect pitch.
You?
Yeah, you can just play
dude,
anything.
Awesome.
Yeah, I remember Joe was once playing something, and he's like, so we play a B, and then Aiden's just standing right behind him, and he goes, B flat, and goes here, and he's like, oh, fuck. I've never seen Joe look so good.
That's lovely, man.
Dear diary, today is day 7 trying to get Sarah to notice me. It feels like I'm invisible to her. Anyways, the other day she recently changed her Zoom background to a pic of her. I can't even describe how pretty she is. I can't wait to see my girlfriend. I definitely gotta make sure my teeth look white in case she sees this and asks for my Snapchat. She's not ready for a mature man like me. Just look at her. She is perfect. Not a single one of your mom's dad. Sarah, today you're mine. Look at that hair, oh natural. Yeah, she's gonna want to dive into this. And those push-ups, they've been paying off.
right now.
What is it, James? I need to get on a work call in 3 minutes.
Mom, I'm going to talk to Sarah today. Today's the day. I'm going to talk to her.
You got this, James. You got Dad's charm.
All right, class, we're going into breakout rooms. So go into your breakout room.
I got it!
James, you will not be able to get this girl's information in a breakout room. What are you thinking?
Hey Sarah, would you like to revise each other's essays?
Yeah, sure. Oh my god, Sarah, how's that guy? Did you guys ever know?
Stop, he's good. Oh my god, I'm trying to snap right now. Chloe!
She was totally hitting on me during Angela's class. I got life on easy mode.
You're lying.
No, I swear on my cast is life.
Yeah, I believe you.
Stating that people ought to remain indoors.
New York, considered to be one of the last safe havens, is the latest city to have lost power.
With officials gone missing, the central government has effectively collapsed and is no longer able to provide aid.
With the death toll rising higher and higher, all we can do is pray.
That's kind of a bummer. Something come up?
Oh, yeah.
I don't know.
Yeah.
Hey. Connor said he's got it stuck in nothing. It's not coming. He's totally canceling on us.
Didn't they have the fire start, though?
Yeah, that means no more fire. Anyway, the back of the tent's building up, so can you guys help me at least one of you guys?
Yeah, sure. Hey guys, check this out.
Hey, what is it?
What are you guys looking at?
Looks like a cross or something.
Well, Rick, now you unleash the demons and we're all gonna die.
Hey, can I see you for a second?
Thank you. happening in small towns. In other news, Daintree is releasing a new feature for select Prime members. They are calling it preemptive packaging. It uses Daintree's AI to decide what you are going to order before you need it. More on this after the break.
Hey, could you grab some tissues? We're off toilet paper.
No!
of the temperature is 45 degrees. For your safety and comfort, please remain seated with your mask fastened until exiting the premises.
We will soon indicate that we have parked the gate and that it is safe for you to move about. But for now, do we have any questions from the audience about these last 6 films?
And can we get all the production teams up to the top? So once again, you can ask about the filmmaking process, or how film ideas came about, or difficulties you've encountered while filming. Yes, in the back. How many takes of the oatmeal footage exploding happen?
No, that's putting it into the microwave.
Oh, putting it into the microwave.
So, our very other.
It's the same 2 shots repeated about 10 times.
And, you know, we were trying to learn how to do an explosion effect, and the first thing we used was an egg. Remember when we first used an egg, and then it actually sounded like a gunshot? And then it gave me memories back to my childhood. It was great.
Yes. How difficult or easy was the collaboration process around the film?
It was certainly difficult being able to, like, coordinate everybody to get together on set for days, because we had people that wanted to be fully virtual. We had people that were, you know, on set every day, and it was hard finding things for everybody to do, in a way. And so, just pulling everyone together as a team, that's what really made the movie possible.
Sorry, I'm not one of the directors. I just wanted to say that it can also be difficult based on the script you have. I know that some scripts didn't turn out exactly how they went, you know, on film. And so when you're tackling some difficult subjects, and it can kind of, when you actually get to the filming, you say, you know, sometimes it's time to revise. So it can be very, very difficult, even on something that can see.
So my arc was nyctophobia nights, and I'd say one of the more difficult things was, especially near the beginning of the project, all 5 of our group members are like fully committed to sports as well as other extracurriculars. So it was incredibly difficult to find a time that worked for everybody to shoot particularly. And once we got later into like the filming process, once most of it was filmed and there was moving on to editing, it was kind of hard to synchronize editing between, I mean, mainly Skyler and I.
Yeah.
Because, I don't know, our software was just very unintuitive, and we had a lot of problems syncing up our progress with each other. Yeah, it's just a lot of tech.
Yeah, you have a question?
I do, yes. For Sim, how many hours of filming did it take to edit it down to, what was that, 6 minutes? Or
how many initial hours of filming did you have to edit it down?
It took a lot of hours. We had some situations, and we had to do a lot of reshoots, coordinating this filming stuff, but yeah, it was definitely a grind editing up that thing, especially with all of our reshoots. And I had like 300 clips on the software I was using, so just like navigating that and figuring out. But yeah.
There's a question on the live stream.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Well, it's yours. Just read it out.
Okay. The question is, they said, great work, everyone. The question is, why do the filmmakers think so many of the pieces, all except for the balloon and the crushed one and the oatmeal, I think, are so
everybody independently thought, oh, it would be really cool if we did like an action scene. And so we just had a whole bunch of people doing that. The themes of each movie together in one big production, one big show like this, were not considered. So it was a whole bunch of pieces that we all individually and separately wrote. And so it's really just chance that a lot of them were like that. But it is an interesting observation.
Another possibility is that, well, making like comedy actually land for a general audience is also very hard. So that's why, like, a big reason we didn't have a lot of like comedic based movies, because it's hard to like kind of land those things when it's such a broad and like subjective like sense of emotion instill. So a lot of people think might think that it's better to have like an action centric film because it's more appealing to a more general audience as well.
Also, it's fun for the kiddies.
That too.
Curious for some of you, how many hours would you say you invested total to make some of your films? If you had up each person hours to make a 6 to 10 minute film?
We probably had close to, a lot of our bit we put out dark, we had light scenes and dark scenes, which kind of had dead time in the middle. We probably put like 14 plus hours into just filming, maybe 20. And then editing was probably upwards of 20 or 30, depending on what we got done in a day. Yeah.
Our film had at least like 25 hours of shooting and about 50 hours of editing. And so it's an awful lot of time we put into these.
Advice for each filmmaker: bring water.
Bring water.
Busy and the actors are pretty busy. But I did delete the timeline like multiple times, which I think added to the work I have to do. This is my first time using Premiere. But I think for how small, how little footage you were able to get, I think I did like 10 hours, but mostly because I had to redo the movie a lot of times.
What was the hardest scene in the film? Directed towards anyone?
Yeah, the chase scene in ours was pretty tough because we were dealing with other people outside of our group, a bunch of parents, and we weren't used to that. It was really chaotic of our own fault, and we had to get used to filming with other people and directing people outside of our group. We got it in the end, but it was rough at first.
Our hardest shot to film was, we were fans of Packing, by the way, or PPJ. Our hardest shot was by far the one where it's from the perspective of the box looking up, because I was sitting on the ground, like through this empty box, filming up at PJ, and he was just standing over me like this. And so he just kept cracking up. It took us like a good 20 minutes to film a 2 second shot, at least.
When we had this shoot inside the microwave, because we're lacking, we share like the same 5 brain cells, we didn't think about what it is. We're like, hold on, but don't phones explode in the microwave, so how are we gonna do that? And it's like, oh yeah, just sit it in there or whatever, but it's like, while staring at our phones in the microwave, I like felt like a very strong urge to just turn it on and just see what happens. So I guess that was kind of hard to hold myself back from doing.
I think for our group Simp, the hardest scene to film was probably the Zoom scenes, because it was a bit hard to like get on like a screen on the screen, but we figured it out, so.
For the last scene, like dinner time, it was me, my mom, and my dad, and it took us probably about like 20 tries and our camera was dying, and it was just a whole train wreck. We just sat, it's really hard to act with people you know well, and it's just the most awkward thing ever, but we ended up like taking a bunch of pieces from all our dinner times.
I got asked about this earlier, and I really enjoyed being able to answer it, actually. So we have a very realistic looking weapon in our film, we have the packaging, and then we also have a carjacking and a mugging occur, all in like fairly public spaces. And so it was actually kind of difficult to I had to communicate a lot with the Fairfax PD, the Nobel PD, I think a cop car came by our shoes like twice, and then like, he's like, hey, why are you wearing a big black cloth hood over your face? He's like, oh, we're just filming, it's a high school film. I recall for the mugging scene, we actually had to, a police officer, we told them about it, and they're like, oh, it's fine. And they actually have a police officer come on site and be like, hey, we're just here in case any other cop show up.
This is what was, like, this isn't necessarily a scene, but one aspect of it, which was extremely difficult, was color grading and getting certain scenes to match the lighting of others, especially because, as I mentioned, some scenes have to be shot at different times of the day. So trying to get them to line up to create a continuity with, like, for example, in our film, Fear, we had a lot of scenes that were shot like in the day, it was supposed to be set in the night. So we try to set the color to like a darker hue, especially like a blue, to kind of instill like the continuity of like nightfall. And that was extremely difficult. So I want to thank all of our volunteers over there, Benny, the live stream, for helping us a crap ton with that. That was painful, and I cannot thank it all or none.
We have another question over here. Yeah. Favorite moments from our films. I think for my group, the favorite, as you were saying, animation mixed in with people acting, I think one of the coolest moments is when I look back and see the animated wolf coming towards me, and it's like, what? Where'd that come from? I don't know, I think it's cool.
Yeah, just seeing that, like, because obviously there's no wolf when we're filming. So once the animation was actually implemented over the footage, and I mean, Skylar and I, when we saw it the first time, both of us actually freaked out. It was so cool to see that. It was really cool to see that actually implemented, like exactly as I mentioned as well.
Favorite moment from Gabe's film, I think, is a pretty obvious one. I mean, he falls back on the chair.
Also, he's crying.
Okay, yeah, so that, the falling scene, that was not, I can't see. That was not intentional. I was just trying to lean back in the chair, and I just totally sent it backwards, and I broke so much stuff in my room. I tore down my own glass, broke the bowl, like, all that. Crying scene, though, that was genuine, okay?
Favorite alright, well, I think that'll wrap up the Q&A session. Thank you for your questions. Thank you.
Still gonna play it or no? Okay, because I was gonna drop it.